attending this session. My name is Jun Huang, and I come from Taiwan. In this session, I will share the past experience to build Android and try to contribute something to an Android open source project. And then I will talk about some tools about our past work. So first, what does the organization name originate from? It's another head talk, so it's it can hear. I have no idea how to pronounce it in English, so it's just our name. So it's a geek name. And about me, I can contribute something to Android open source project, and I also developer of Linaro, and contribute some other open source project. And in the past, I was the software group lead at OpenLocal. So I try to make something to introduce myself, you just symbolize into two icons. So one is Taiwan, a small place, and another is ELCE, Android Open Source Project. So small place, here. Okay. And our goal is try to shine in small place like a nice thing at block. So we hack Android from small pieces of source tree, like C library, linker, and various functionality and the system tool and validation like that. In the meanwhile, we work with some commercial partners like on Edgeware in Taiwan, MediaTek, and Open Embedded Software Foundation, which is an organization in Japan. So our model is really simple. We just try to do some open source work, and our partner can benefit from these open source efforts. So this is an agenda for today's talk. So first one is build Android distribution. And in the meanwhile, we learn some lessons from building Android distribution, and then we try to ensure the quality because it's a community work. Since it's a community work, there are many changes involved. And finally, I will talk about enhancement back to the community. You can see some optimization on tweaks and even new features. Okay. Initially, we just want to enable wireless connectivity feature on Android for our hardware partners. So the reason why we have to build community Android distribution is very simple, just for such idea. But finally, we encountered many problems. We suffer from some performance and stability issues in LSP source 3. So we try to fix it. And we create an open source project called ZeroStroy, basically an environment where we can develop. The reference target is BeagleBone. And might be the variant. We call it DBK 8000. So what does ZeroStroy deliver? Initially, it enables some hardware like like BeagleBone, PandaBone, and Snowball is ongoing. We provide the full source code for HL, hardware abstraction layer. In LSP, there is less HL source code, so we just try to provide the full source code, like motion sensor driver, like Bluetooth and Wi-Fi enable parts. And since Android is designed for smartphone, if you use the board like PicoBook, you have to you will face a problem like there is no cursor, or the window manager always crash due to limited resource. So we just try to fix the problem from window manager, large screen, and do some fixes for network connectivity. Because initially Android has no Ethernet support, so we just added the support back. Also, we improved the performance. We did some unspecific optimization and graphics development. Finally, we added some new features like Bluetooth HID, so you can use a Bluetooth keyboard mouse. The feature is added in Gingerbread and Ice Cream, as far as I know. But we already did last year. Also, we support external modem and some 3D effects. You can see the video, the custom launcher. All of them are open source. In fact, we are not really want to make yet another Android distribution. We just wish to help the community. So just for just a test bed. So we think that valuable change should be merged in upstream of the community project. That should be better for all. So our strategy and the policy is open source effort. We do open source effort and try to get it merged into Android. We focus on small part, but it's small but important part, like torture, C library, diamond linker. Diamond linker is important because if you want to enable Android on low power device, you will face some problem like memory usage and upgrading start time. So if you can optimize the diamond linker, the manual usage and the boot time can be reduced. And for scale, which is a 2D library, and something like software OpenGL, because some device has no GPU, and so on, some system libraries. We develop some system utility for benchmarking, for testing. And then we work with Linaro to build a validation infrastructure. Okay, so that's the important part. We try to submit and share our changes to LSP and Sanjuma. Sanjuma is a very famous Android community, and we submit the above changes. And yet another is Android X86, which is a project to enable Android on PC-like device. Android X86 is another bigger community. And the final is Linaro, a very strong technology base. So our working model is initially we think of some feature, or we try to figure out what's the system bottleneck. For example, we want to enable, or we want to have the feature of Bluetooth mouse. So initially we load the patch and submit to Sanjuma or Android X86, and ask the community member to try our patches. We get several feedback, and we try to work with the community members. So finally, many distribution has merged our changes. For example, signature mask supports Bluetooth keyboard since the 6th release. So everything from the above sounds fine, but we learn several lessons from ELCE when we want to submit patches to Android open source project. In my opinion, contributing to ASP is art, because you never know how Google thinks of your patches. I think that's really a problem. And there is Garrett, which is a code review system. You can submit your patches on Garrett, but you cannot guarantee Google employee, Google engineer will review, or they just drop. And even more, ignore your changes. So that's a problem. And Android open source project is not a traditional open source project. So you have to be patient. So in my opinion, Android open source project like open source pretender. Please ignore my English. I look at the dictionary. I find the word pretender. And there is no public roadmap for Android, so our team just make a decision that we ignore the modification against Android framework because we have no idea about Android framework. So most of our changes are against debian, libc, and some other library like Scala and so on. We never contribute Android framework because we already have some painful experience about that. Okay. That's another fact that the merger change usually show up in next one or next two release. So it's really a problem if you want to make contribution in many change set, and in the condition of non-national Google's roadmap, it's really hard to track, and even more you have no idea how to submit related changes because Google developer might not interest in your changes at all, so it's really hard to do. To these things. We try to contribute to Android open source project before. I will show you some changes I did. You can use the repo tool and you can use repo for all. So I just show us something, git log to grab our changes. So we already did something, so you can see the screen just scrolling. Currently about 41 changes in Android open source project. But in fact, we submit more than that number. We submit more than 50 patches to ELCE, but only 40 get merged. And all the patches are run C library and some system paths. You can use Android contribute mailing list to discuss with Google engineer, but it's not really clear to for their attitude or their roadmap, because a Google engineer signed a DA and they did not talk about the future part. And I think the most difficult part is you can use Git, you can use Garrett, which is code review system, but you have to use the get it on invisible repository, which is internal and firewall git stream. So just imagine it. You send patch to Google, but Google tell you something that doesn't exist in your site. So that's really hard to make contribution. So this is how Gadget work. Gadget is a neat tool Google provides it, so you can submit your patches, and there are many. You can make many change states. So after Google developer review it, you can after the patch is reviewed, Google developer could push to Git and get into AOSP. That's really good, but the problem is here. Here, upstream means AOSP master branch and Google internal stream. You can see that, but you have no idea about Google internal stream. But a patch only accepts, a patch is accepted only when both Git stream have no conflict or approved by Google engineer. So that is really, really a problem. You have to pay more attention to think about the path or think of the strategy you want to make a contribution or you want to work with Google's engineer. And another problem is for some repository there is no explicit change history. For example, the GCC. GCC itself has a long history, but if you check the AOSP, you only see the history is just so small. That's an Android style open source model. You have no idea about the detailed change. And since Gingerbread, it gets much greater for torsion part, so there is a lot. You still have no idea about why it changed. For example, I contribute something here, there are three patches just load back. No reason why, just Google engineer just load back. That's because Google have an internal tree which has a more detailed history, more aggressive development, but it's poor. The changes according to the requirement or according to the release flow. So if you are in the open source world, you only see just small change. But Google has the full history. That's the problem. It's really hard to work. So the observed AOSP working model, in my opinion, is mass branch is a bridge between AOSP and the Google internal tree. There are already many organizations and companies to contribute their patches. But the problem is that only Google engineer to review changes. So-called mass branch consists of two parts. One is the latest AOSP, another is the partial change by Google, so like security fees and bug fees. So in my past experience, if you want to know more about Google's code, the best way is just send patch if possible. So for example, I was curious about which version of zlib yesterday. So yesterday zlib is version 1.2.3, and I sent patches to 1.2.5 and 1.2.4 and so on. I just trying the version. If there is a conflict, it means Google has changed the code base of ZLib. Otherwise, they they didn't change it. So that's a way to learn something from Google. You just save pages. So it's my understanding of Android. How is the revolution a big change? Software is basically evolution, so it's steadily improved. But Android is highly coupled with hardware. So it's a problem. It is not smooth. And you have to jump every release. And sometimes you have no source code due to some non-technical reason like gingerbread, and we don't know why. But if you look into the functional view, for example, it's Android 1.5 and compared to Android 2.3, you can see some parts change like OpenGL versions. And, David VN has just in time compile, and C library has SMP fix. But you can see the overall design is consistent. But the current working model, I mean the AOSP model, prevents from community to contribute something. That's a problem. And if you check the ELCE to make some statistics for gingerbread, so it's just an example. If you compare from Froyo to gingerbread, you can see many changes except Google's. The two parts is Google, another is the third party. Like Sony Ericsson, like QIC, Qualcomm Innovation Center. You can see something really interesting, like Intel Nokia.
Why?
Because there is a repository called BlueZ. And Intel and Nokia are the major contributor of BlueZ. So the commit were correct in AOSP. But the real problem is that some really useful changes, some really useful modification, for example, taken from CyanogenMod, usually absent. So that's really the problem because the review process is very, very long, and you never know the detail of Android framework modification. So that is a problem. If you want to make really useful change, let's say Bluetooth profile, if you want to improve Bluetooth profile, such change always be rejected by Google because Google already has their idea in their future release. So if you work on the old code base and try to contribute, you usually get jet. So we are here. We just trying to contribute a small part, like C library. And the C library is very, very clear. Just a system call and some service like PostgreSQL. And we just fix some bug, try to enhance the performance. So such kind of change are always upset by Google if there is no conflict. But in other part, we are hard to track or hard to work with the AOSP. That's a problem. And we try to build an Android distribution. When we build our Android distribution, we have to ensure the quality because we have to merge several changes from community. So that's a problem. So our mission in our development is trying to improve user experience in SOC. So we are targeting some popular SOC or some advanced SOC, and we not only get Android working on that, but also try to improve the system spec. Okay. So initially, we want to deliver the good parts of open source. And we develop some tool like ZeroSbench, like Esther. ZeroSbench is a benchmark tool. Esther is a system level testing tool. And Lava is a joint development effort with Linaro to bring the automated validation process. Okay, and we trying to write some patches to improve the performance. So for Lava, you can see Lava is automated. You can build the source automatically and deploy it to the device. After the validation, you can see the report on web. You can track several builds. So for Linaro, it's really easy to track every build for every board, like for Samsung, for Freescale, and so on. ZeroSbench is a comprehensive open source benchmark. As we know, is the most complete one, most complete open source one. I could not find another open source tool. Okay. So include some virtual machine benchmarking, OpenGL and JavaScript engine performance. You can use it. You can just download it. ZeroSbench. The first character is zero. Okay. So, graphics and 3D, 2D, and virtual machine, and some even like web. And you can upload your results to the web, so we can analyze the results on server side. And that is really important. And we have a 2500 results. Based on your contribution by uploading the result, we can normalize the change. Also, we developed a Android functional testing tool. Inside Android, according to CDD, device manufacturer must include a monkey framework. That's a building framework. You can do something like a monkey try, so you can invoke some package and do some batch testing like touch screen and keyboard. But that is really stupid because you have no idea about the scenario. So we just developed another one black box test. Wow. We call it Esther. So you can make the scenario for testing, and there is a simple IDE. You just have to catch the icons, and we will try to play back. So you can use the Esther to play Angry Bird if you already make the scenario. So you can play Angry Bird for 1,000 times, 100 times, and check the memory leak. Or check the stability of system image. That's really important because if you use monkey, the building one, just a random input and random test, which is the limit. But with Esther, you can do many UI testing and you can set your checkpoint. For example, you can bring out Bluetooth network or Wi-Fi network and try to check if the network connection is ready or not. Okay, and in the meanwhile, we try to bring this down.
Excuse me, could you just go back?
Okay.
I personally, I think this is amazing. I'm just wondering, can you actually loop? Can you actually tell your system to actually loop and do some stuff? I mean, because I see a linear progression here, but can you actually tell it to go back?
Okay, so the operation model is really easy because every Android device have to enable ADB, which is Android Debugger Bridge. So you can use the USB wire. So you think of this PC is a device. So you can use the USB wire to share the screenshot through USB. USB is very fast enough. And we use OpenCV, OpenCV library to recognize the screen. And we set some interval to capture every screen. So if your program like Angry Bird, we just try to scan the brain from the predefined script.
Okay.
So you can just capture. And OpenCV is very powerful. So you don't have to make the full icon because you can use the smaller one, just kind of mathematics. It's a simple work, and you can find the source code from Esther. So it's really working. And the PC, in the PC part, we support Linux and the Windows already. Okay. So, okay. So I will talk about the enhancement and what we already delivered to the community. I'm sorry for my bad English. I had to explain it. So just use the video. Okay, that's our logo. Zero is there. As I told before, we emphasize on the user experience. So boot time is a really important part. So we already improved the boot times 2 years ago, and that is effort 2 years ago. We just try to get into faster by avoiding the doubly initialized hardware, and we deliver a new bootload like called QI. Also, we did some un-optimization, which already merged in AOSP build. This part is continued work, and we work with Linaro for specific optimization. And we introduced our installer to make Android distribution to easier to into target. It just format an SD card and input. The small Android will share everything. And we even support the external model because we build most development board has no model. So we make some simple hack to enable switch model. Then you can do more development later. And to verify the performance and 3D graphics, we modify Android framework to introduce some animation. So you can see some interesting animation. I will emphasize that that's not the reason we don't want to get a fancy part. We just want to demonstrate the GPU or the software OpenGL engine to be. And it's our automatic testing. And eventually, it merged into Lava, Linaro's validation framework. So you can see it can deploy the image into target BeagleBone automatically. So the first thing when you go to the office, just check the report and fix some regression or think about if there is something to improve. And there is a benchmarking, 2D, 3D, and so on. So we are trying to deliver this kind of enhancement back to the community. So what we already do is share the patch to ELCE extension mind and to X86. And the most important thing is we we claim we provide 100% open source code base, including the OpenGL engine. We developed the world's first OpenGL ES adaptation layer based on Mesa. So you can enable your device if your device already has Linux OpenGL support. That's really important because until now there are only two 100% open source OpenGL adaptation layer and open source engine for Android. One is our part. Our work, another is Sensor, but Sensor community project, but it's not, the latter is not complete. And we do some unspecific contribution, and you can see something present in the video already. So for example, we after our contribution, our work, you can see Debian virtual machine it get even better, better now. So that's the original score. That's the new one. So you can see some 14-point part is improved. And this page already merged in Synergy. So that's the reason why you will feel. That's one of the reasons why you feel Synergy is better, because there are some part like this. And the 2D, for 2D you can see some parts already improved, so it looks much better. It looks better, sorry. And we have our customer and have our partner to improve the device. So you can see the original is here, and we have our customer to get better. And eventually we try to decouple the source code, the contribution back to community. So community can benefit from our work, so as our customer. Another is OpenGL, you can see get better, even even our device has no GPU. So how can we do that? We try to optimize memory, optimize the NVM, because for ARMv7, there is a really useful instruction called IE. You can do fast NVM conversion, and we try to optimize some essential ARM functions like memory copy and string copy and so on, and we even optimized linker. There are many approaches to that already implemented in GNU system, but never in Android. So we just try to rework Android. So we modified the pre-linker system library and so on. You can see the normalized linker time. Originally, it's here, and you can see many application start time was reduced. If your hardware is less powerful, let's say unable, the number will get better because of the complexity. So how can we do that? We just reduce the number of ELF symbol lookup. So you can see with our changes, that's original and that's the new one. Almost no ELF symbol lookup, so the start time can be reduced. And everything is open source now. You can check our source code later. Okay. So with GNU hash, you can reduce the lookup and many greatly. And we implement the Bluetooth HID, which consists of two parts. One is this library, another is Android framework. Unfortunately, the Android framework never gain much in ELCE. And we do some UI customization So you can see the UI looks different. So it's really important if you want to develop some product like TV or tablet. You might have some idea for advanced UI. And another part is the boot time optimization. I already mentioned chip loader, so it's very, very small. And only one stage loader is almost 30 kilobytes. And it should be fast enough, simple enough to boot. And we have another part, we call it optimized hibernation. It's based on task on ice. I will show you something to show the video. Faster and boot time. We can boot and draw in six seconds. And in our development environment, we can reduce to 5 seconds. The full functional, including user space, can just bring. You can see the 6 times from loader to full functional draw. And this part is you can see it's full function and open source. You can check our kernel modification. And we plan to do further boot time optimization, not only task analysis, but also Android heap image optimization. So the idea is if you can reduce the image, the memory usage as possible as you can, the boot time could be reduced. And there are there are a problem for that David could be in just in time. It contribute many memory fragment, which is not bad. So we are going to modify it to improve David could be in, so you can have a more compact memory usage. It means a faster time. So with some optimization, we can put a full function and draw it in 5 seconds. Okay. Finally, you can check our roadmap. One is zero story. And most of the modification or improvement in zero story already merged in other projects like CyanogenMod. And eventually, we want to make our contribution back to ELCE, but it's hard for a technical reason. And you can check our source code, including that Facebook time and our wiki mail minister. Feel free to discuss with us. It's our pleasure to discuss with you, and you make. Business connection, if any. So, thanks again for attending this. I'll say thanks again to my sponsor, EdgeWay. EdgeWay is a Taiwanese hardware company who know the importance of software. And EdgeWay already sponsors me for a long time. Yeah. That's the reason why I can share some experience, share some open source work to you. So if you anyone has a problem or question. Okay, thanks for your attending. Good afternoon. Thank you.